want to have an experiment with all of you today. So I have a clock, and what we're going to do, you see the little red hand? Hi, buddy, how you doing? You see the little red hand? We're going to watch the red hand. That's called the second hand. And when I tell you go, that means everyone has to be really, really quiet. No noise, okay? No talking. You have to be really, really quiet. Can you do that? In other words, shh. Are you ready? Get set. Go. Time's up. Time's up. Wow, that was a long time, wasn't it? It seemed like forever. As a matter of fact, you were so quiet, they were too. They must have been very, very patient. Did you notice that your pastor, though, I wasn't very patient, was I? I was slapping my knee. I was tapping my foot. I kept looking at the clock, hoping that the time would be up. Those 30 seconds went really, really slow. Grandma's up there, isn't she? Yeah, I see Grandma. Hi. Yeah, hi, Grandma. Very good. So, what's the point? Sometimes we get really impatient, don't we? What's coming very soon? And you just can't wait. What's coming? Christmas. Yeah, because you see all the presents under the tree, and you just can't wait. You become impatient. But you know, James tells us today, be patient, therefore, brothers, for the coming of the Lord. You know, here in this Christmas time, we know that Jesus has already come. That's why we celebrate Christmas. But we know that Jesus is coming again, isn't he? Jesus, though, he works according to his own time. Jesus has a clock, not like this clock, though. It's a divine clock. And Jesus will come for us when he determines that it's time to come. So if we are impatient, and if we can't wait for him, well, you know, that means that we could be led away from Jesus. So we have to stay focused on Jesus. Jaden, stay focused on Jesus. So we stay focused on Jesus, right? And that's what James is telling us today. Be patient, therefore, my brothers, for the coming of the Lord. We know that Jesus is coming again. How do we know this? How do we know that Jesus is coming again? Because he told us. Has Jesus ever lied to you?
No.
No, very good. Jesus has never lied to us. Although we tell lies, but Jesus does not lie, because God is not a liar. Jesus said that he would come for us, that he would be born as a baby, that he would go to the cross and die for us, that he would rise again on the third day. He said that he would come again, and that's his final promise. So therefore, it's important for us to be very, very patient. Be very patient, Jaden. Be very patient. All of us should be very patient, for we know that the Lord will come for you. And that's why today, as you look at the candles up here, you see that the pink candle's lit. That's the candle of peace, the candle of joy. It's the candle that shows us that as we are patient, we will know that there's a joyful day coming. And that joyful day is when? No, the last day. Because Christmas has already come. That's already happened. But we know that Jesus is coming again. So it's not about, Christmas isn't about all the gifts. It's about Jesus. And the real Christmas is on the last day. So, not that Caden's going to get a bundle of switches or anything like that. But we know that there's a greater gift coming. And what's that greater gift, Caden? Eternal
faith.
Well, faith, eternal life, faith in God. That's why we are patient. Okay, let's fold our hands and let's bow our heads as we close our eyes and let us pray. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, help us to be patient. We, oh Lord, want you to come back so quickly. Oh Lord, it is hard for us to be patient. It's hard for us to wait, but teach us, Lord Jesus, that your day will come. And teach us, Lord Jesus, that even though we cannot see you now, you are always with us. You are always, always with us. For you have made a promise that you'll never leave or forsake us. Therefore, Lord Jesus, we pray that you come quickly indeed. And all the children said...